above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man. You were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified and laid behind a stone, you lived to die, rejected and
everybody, and happy Easter. Christ is risen, hallelujah. He is risen indeed. We're going to follow the order of service on page 119 in your prayer books if you would like to follow along with me. First, let us begin with our first hymn.
Strength, my song, this cornerstone. through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand.
In Christ alone, who took on
secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. Jesus said, this is the great and first commandment, and a second is like it. You shall love your neighbour as yourself. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, confident in God's forgiveness. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death, to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Christ Jesus, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be praise, honour and thanksgiving, now and for all eternity. Amen. We're going to have our readings from Scripture.
Reading is from Isaiah 55. Verses 1-11. Come, all of you who are thirsty, come to the waters, and you will have no money. Come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Why spend money on what is not bread, and your labour on what does not satisfy? Listen, listen to me, and eat what is good, and you will delight in the richest of fare. Give ear and come to me. Listen, that you may live. I will make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love promised to David. See, I have made him a witness to the peoples, a ruler and a commander of the peoples. Surely you will summon nations you know not, and nations you do not know will come running to you. Because the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has endowed you with splendor. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call on him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord and he will have mercy on them. And to our God, for he will freely pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater, so is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the book of Romans, chapter 6, verses 3-11. Or don't you know that all of us who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that, just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. For if we have been united with him in death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. For we know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body ruled by sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves to sin. Because anyone who has died has been set free from sin. Now, if we die with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. For we know that since Christ was raised from the dead, he cannot die again. Death no longer has mastery over him. The death he died to sin once and for all. But the life he lives to God. In the same way, count yourselves dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus Christ, according to Matthew chapter 28, beginning at verse 1. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. After the Sabbath, at dawn, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, he has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you." So the woman hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them. "Greetings," he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." For the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. How wonderful that we are here celebrating Easter together. You know, this is an Easter that none of us will forget. Could you ever imagine in your wildest dreams that to attend an Easter service, you would have to do it in front of a television or a computer screen? I couldn't have imagined it. You know, it's interesting, as a church, we've been embracing technology for a number of years now, and our contemporary services have been online for a few years now through Facebook. But now we find ourselves in a situation where even those of us who hold a traditional faith and would normally attend in a very traditional building, find ourselves even online. And so it's with that in mind that I'm filming here in our beautiful St. Thomas's Church. And you can see our picture of St. Thomas behind us, and what a wonderful building we have. What a blessing it's been for so many generations. And when I think about the legacy that previous generations gave us in building this church and in creating these wonderful grounds. But I guess I'm equally reminded that here we are still as the church, even though we're not in this beautiful building. I'm reminded that we are the church. We don't go to church. Yet the missing gathering is at the heart of our struggle. And the thing we love about our buildings is it's the place where we gather. And for some of us, it's generational. Our parents and now us and our children and grandchildren gathering together in the one place. So here we are. How do we make the most of our circumstances? Well, you know what? God is still God, and his love is still as profound and life-transforming as ever. And we are his people, and that has not changed. And so we're going to celebrate this Easter basically on the knowledge that God is still good, and that what he did for us on the cross is still the same, and his resurrection to eternal life still means that you and I have resurrection to eternal life. What a wonderful gift this is. What a tremendous privilege it is to be called children of the living God. And at Easter time, we remember the incredible love of our God, who, laying down his glory, laying down his authority, rode on a donkey into Jerusalem, faced a mockery of a trial, faced the persecution of the very people he came to save, you know, received a dreadful Roman flogging enough to kill a man, you know, carrying his own cross to Golgotha, and then dying one of the most gruesome and horrendous deaths imaginable, with the 6-inch nails in his hands and feet, and drowning effectively, a terrible death that it was. And he did all this motivated by love. And then on the resurrection, we see the fulfillment of that love, because death could not hold him down. The King of Glory could not be held down by a grave. And so we see the wonderful story of the stone being rolled away. We see the empty grave, and we're about to encounter the risen Lord Jesus in coming days as the various witnesses recount their stories. How glorious and how wonderful. Do you know, for me, it's an Easter we'll never forget. And there's been so many unique things happening, you know, learning to have authentic and faithful worship via a camera and down a television screen. What tremendous learnings that is for us as a church. And for so many of you here watching, I'm so proud of you, because I know for some of you, the thought of being able to actually get on your computers or on your phones or on your televisions and learning how to connect and do all this, you know, a couple of months ago would have seemed impossible. But you know, this is the thing, we serve a God for whom all things are possible. And I'm very proud of you all for being here today and sharing in this moment with me. You know, in preparation for this week, I had some firsts as well. I went to the hospital and did protective personal protective equipment training so that when I go into the hospital and I'm with people who may have the virus, that I can be protected as I go in. Because you may not know, but we're still continuing to take the love of God into those places. We're still anointing with oil for healing. We're still laying hands and praying for people. We're just doing it with a whole lot of plastic gloves and masks and all sorts of things on us. And I'd love you to keep praying for our hospital chaplains, for Leanne and Kim, for myself and all the other clergy of Port Macquarie who are going to hospitals, and indeed all the clergy, you know, and parishes that you're watching from. Keep praying for them, and pray for our doctors and our nurses and all those amazing people who are in there. But you know, for me, it was so surreal to realize that you cannot stop the good news of Jesus Christ. You cannot stop the gospel of love, because the gospel of love does not care about the obstacles. The gospel of love will keep going. And you know, no matter how much plastic I had on my hands and on my face and on my eyes, I had to protective glasses on my eyes as well as my glasses. And you know, nothing could stop my desire to take the love of God into people's lives. And you know, I know for you, no matter how you're feeling, right, maybe you're on your own and you're single. I know at this time being single and on your own is a really hard place to be. But I want you to know that you're not alone. The Holy Spirit is with you. He is in you. He lives in you, and He lives in your presence. And you know, as a church, we're with you as well, and we're praying with you. And I encourage you, you know, take up a habit of ringing people in your network. You know, every day ring somebody. Just say, "How are you going?" Just connect with them, because you don't know what's going on. People's lives continue. You know, people are still, you know, going to doctors. People are still having the struggles in their lives. People are still grieving loved ones and missing grandkids and all the things that normally happen in life. The life we live hasn't stopped. And so, you know, it's so important that we stay connected with each other. And, you know, I think for me, celebrating the resurrection at this time, you know, one of the things that the nurse educator spoke to us when we were doing our training was, she said, they're so encouraged at the moment because the isolating we're doing is working. And that curve that I keep talking about is flattening off. And the number of new people getting the virus is starting to flatten off. And our hospital system is not being overwhelmed. It's so encouraging, you know. And the thing about being a Christian at Easter time is we're a people of resurrection. We're a people of great hope. We're a people who believe that God has a plan for humanity and God has a plan for the world. And so, you know, this Easter, I want you to know that this too will pass. And God will lead us into life, and God will lead us into joy, and God will lead us into blessing, and God will lead us into relationships with each other, and God will continue to be our guide and our hope for the future. So church, hang in there. We're going to get through this together. God is with you. The church is with you. Be the church. Pray for each other and love one another in any way you possibly can. Happy Easter to everyone. We're going to have a time of prayer.
Holy Father, Lord Jesus and Holy Spirit, pray on behalf of our church, Lord, to you at this time of concern that the people have within the church. I pray, Lord, on behalf of our church, for our leadership, steward, the wardens, the parish councillors, and indeed all members of our church here in Port Macquarie. I pray, Father, for our medical people in Port Macquarie, the hospitals, the doctors, nurses, other support staff, keeping them safe in this time of uncertainty. We pray, Lord, for the people that are in those hospitals, whether they have COVID-19 or any other illness, in fact, that call upon your healing hand in their lives. We pray, Lord, for the police that are coordinating people in the town and the surrounding areas that keep people aware of what's taking place, keeping their distance, the 1.5 metre distance between humans. It's normally not the case. Normally we are embracing each other with love and affection. We can't do that yet, and that's wise. Father, I pray also for the local government, our mayor and the mayor's staff, our state government leaders, our national leaders, Scott Morrison, and the federal government and all the people who are showing Australians of how we can beat this by this disease by doing the right thing and keeping apart. Indeed, time will come when this will all end and we'll go back to our normal lives, but with an awareness that if these diseases come again, that we all know how to be best prepared for them. We pray, Lord, for people in the ambulance sector who go and pick up patients, people who are sick, all the hospital people as well. Pray, Lord, for your church in Australia, the Christian church, of all the churches that are currently closed, but can have people do online worshipping, which is the most marvellous invention, that we can do it by computer, whether it be by iPhones or laptops or desktops. And we give you thanks, Father, for the technology that's been invented and created for us to be able to listen to you on your word that's being preached or shared, to comfort each other and hoping for a better life as time goes on after the coronavirus is expelled. So I pray this, Lord. I can stand here and pray all day. I just feel a call to you, to listen to you by your Spirit, just prodding everybody to say, right, what's the right thing to do? And that is to pray. So we thank you, Lord, for your time here now today. So on behalf of the church, we give you praise. We glorify you, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for being with us. And we praise your holy name and your blessed name. In your name, Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Let us together affirm the faith of the Church. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made. Of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Father, we commit ourselves into your care at this time. And at this time we pray a special prayer for healing. And at home, I encourage you to call out the names of those who need God's healing, mercy, and peace at this time. Father, we commit all the names on our prayer chain and our prayer list to you. And Father, all the names that have been called out this morning. Father, I now declare in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, your healing over them. Father, we declare your perfect peace over them. Father, your Son Jesus, who came that we would have life, who came that we would have forgiveness, who came that we would know the presence of your Holy Spirit, we know that he is at home in us, and he who is at home in us is perfect. So, Father, let his perfection be our perfection in the healing of our bodies. And as our Saviour taught us to pray, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Jesus said, "Come to me, all who labour and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest." For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. So we pray. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. At home there today, if you're on your own, I pray that the peace that I give would be yours, and I pray that you would return that peace to me in kind. But if you are in the living room with others, this is a moment which to share the peace with each other. And if you're keeping social distancing, maybe you'll just have to bow and wish them peace. We are the body of Christ. His Spirit is with us. And the peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you. We greet one another in peace. May the Father's love be your love. May the love of the Son redeem you as it has redeemed me. May the love of the Holy Spirit live in you as the Holy Spirit lives in me. Amen.
Should give his only Son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss! The Father turns his face away as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished. Paid my ransom.
ones have paid my ransom.
We're going to follow Thanksgiving number one this morning, and we're going to use the Easter preface. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts, we lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. All glory and honour be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for us, for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. And by his death on the cross, he offered his one true sacrifice for sin and attained an eternal deliverance for his people. And now we give you thanks that you raised him to life triumphant and exalted him in glory. By his victory over our death, the reign of sin is ended. A new day has dawned and a broken world is restored, and we are made whole once more. Therefore, with angels and archangels, with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and this wine. We pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, that we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. From the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And after supper, he took the cup, and again, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Renew us by your Holy Spirit, unite us in the body of your Son, and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise, blessing and honour. Glory and power are yours forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. We who are many are one body, for we all share in the one bread. I encourage you, if you have gifts of bread and wine at home, hold them up now, and we're going to see them as extended communion from what we're doing here today. If you're not comfortable with that, that's fine. Just receive by faith that which you can. But I do offer by faith the extended communion to you. The gifts of God for the people of God. Come, let us take this holy sacrament of the body and blood of Christ in remembrance that he died for us and feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Father, bless these your gifts. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. May there be to us life everlasting through faith in Jesus Christ. Amen. The body of Christ broken for you and for me. The blood of Christ shed for you and for me. Living God, in this holy meal you fill us with new hope. May the power of your love, which we have known in word and sacrament, Continue your saving work among us and give us courage for our pilgrimage and bring us to the joys you promise. Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen. We're going to finish with our final hymn this morning. Remember, Christ is risen. Alleluia. He is risen indeed. Have a blessed Easter, whatever you're doing today. And we're going to keep in contact with you. We're going to be ringing you, emailing you. Don't forget to get online for all our services. Don't forget my daily vlog that I do, which is on our YouTube channel every day. You can see that to be encouraged. And, you know, I'm open to topics and suggestions you might have. So please make comments, let us know. And remember that we're declared ourselves a church on its knees. Pray for each other. Pray for your church. Pray for your nation. Pray for this world. Pray for our hospitals and our medical staff, and let's keep reaching out to each other, because remember, we're called to love our neighbour as ourselves. Bless you.